So, we are all set to move our robot arms. In this video, we will learn how to do that using MoveIt Commander, which is a command line tool to send commands to move our robots. It is one of the ways to interface to the Move Group ROS node. We can start MoveIt Commander with the following command: ROS run MoveIt underscore commander, MoveIt underscore commander underscore cmd line dot py. In the background, this command starts up a ROS node with all the MoveIt configuration we did in the previous video, so that we can ask Move Group node to move our robot arms. This is a very useful tool to test or check our MoveIt configuration to verify if the robot arms actually do what we command them to do. Let's now look at some basic commands in MoveIt Commander. After we start MoveIt Commander, we get a prompt where we can type commands. To find what all different commands we can type, we can use the help command. Remember, we configured groups of links and joints in the MoveIt Setup Assistant for each robot arm in our factory. We can tell MoveIt which group to use for motion planning and execution using the use group name command. For example, use robot 1. Once MoveIt knows which group to use, we can plan and execute motions to the robot poses, that is, the set of joint configurations we defined in the Setup Assistant. Recall that we saw these joint configurations in the SRDF file. They are called name targets in the MoveIt API. This is possible with the command go named underscore target. We can also use the go command to move the end effector of the robot arms by a certain distance in a linear motion in a certain direction. Here, there are six possibilities: up, down, left, right, forward, and backward. And then with the command current, we get the current joint values of the robot arm and also the Cartesian pose of our end effector in the world reference frame. And lastly, we can also run a series of commands using a script file to perform a certain sequence of motions. This is possible with the load command by passing the path to the script file as an argument. Awesome. Then let's see the commands in action and move the robot arms. So, let's start our gazebo simulation and verify if the two robot arms and the turtle bot are correctly displayed. Note that because there are a lot of 3D meshes to be loaded, it might be the case that sometimes the turtle bot or one of the robots might not be visible at all or also spawned with minor position inconsistencies. In such a scenario, just terminate the simulation with Ctrl C and restart it. Good. Now that we are sure all is well, let's start up MoveIt Commander in a new terminal. So we do so with ROS run MoveIt underscore commander, MoveIt underscore commander underscore cmd line dot py. And now we get a prompt where we can type. So first, let's list the possible set of commands we can type here with help. As you can see, we have the go command here. And we also have some other useful commands like wars, planner, and so forth. Feel free to explore them and don't hesitate to make mistakes. You can still learn from the error messages. Okay, let's first tell MoveIt which robot group we want to use. Let's say we will use robot 1. Then, if all goes well, we will see this log message saying we are ready to work with robot 1. Good. Now, let's move the robot to our predefined joint configurations from the Setup Assistant, for example, R1 up. We do this by saying go R1 up. And up goes robot 1. Yay! First movements of the robot arm. Now, let's see some linear motions of our end effector. For example, let's try moving the end effector down by 20 centimeters with go down 0.2. And we see the robot move linearly down by 20 centimeters. Cool. Now, let's read out the current state of the robot with the current command. As you can see, we have the current joint values of our robot one and the current pose of the end effector in the world reference frame. Lastly, let's try the load command. We will first have to create a script file, so let's do that in a new terminal. Okay, so let's call the new file moveit_commander_test. And let's type a bunch of commands in there, like use robot2, go R2 up, and go down 0.1. Let's save the file and get back to the terminal running moveit commander. Then we say load moveit_commander_test. And let's also slightly adjust our view of the simulation to focus on robot2. And then we hit enter, and off goes robot2 on its way executing all our commands one after the other. Nice. Well, it's always fun to watch robots obey our commands and move in a way that makes sense to us, isn't it? By the way, just something to note here is that the motions to predefined joint targets are computed using the RRT Connect algorithm, which is a randomized planner. In short, it samples random valid joint configurations between a start and a target configuration and creates a path out of it. This can mean we could see motions that are not immediately logical to us. But that's okay. That's what random planners do. If you want to create better paths, feel free to read up literature on optimization-based planners and optimized random planners. In the next video, we will learn how to write a ROS node that can do what we just did with MoveIt Commander using the MoveGroup interface. See you after a short coffee break then.